Once we've enabled and configured SDK buffering, it's very important that we actually test that it's working. You can get a nasty surprise later if you think you configured buffering, but in the end, it really wasn't done quite correctly. So to start off with, again, we'll just check to make sure that our two SDK applications here, process book and system management tools, are both indeed registered with the buffer. So we run that by pibufss creg right there. And yeah, we see that process book and system management tools are both on the list. That's great. The next command we're going to be using is something called pibufss-qs for queue statistics. What this shows is what's going into and out of the buffer at any one time. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use system management tools to write to one of the tags on that server. So I could just write in 70. And now when I save it, I'll see that it went through the buffer. So you see that? That change went up. Similarly, if I go to process book and I annotate something, and save it to that tag, I'll see it go through the buffer as well. See? Right there. Okay, so this is nice. We can see data going into and out of the buffer. And I'll point out that as long as the writes and the reads are the same number, that means that the number of pieces of data going into the buffer are also going out to the PI server. If that starts becoming different, that indicates that you have a buildup in the buffer and that maybe you've lost connection to the PI server, which is something that we'll simulate right now. So if in another command line, I can simulate a network outage and a disconnect from the PI server using pibufss-bc stop. So what this does, it just simulates a network outage. Okay. And now if I write something to the PI server, I'll see that the writes and the reads are different numbers. So what I sent to the buffer is staying in the buffer and hasn't made it to the PI server because we've disconnected from the PI server. And it'll just stay that way until we reconnect. So to reconnect, I can just run that same command, but this time just say start. And we should see the buffer empty out right away. And there it goes. See that? Now the writes and the reads are the same number. Okay, so what we've done here is we've checked that our two SDK applications were registered with the buffer, they were sending data through the buffer, and that the buffer actually buffered data. It's important that you check and test this every time you configure buffering, whether it be API buffering or SDK buffering.